right, so in this video, we will subtract mixed numbers. Look at our first example. Always evaluate those denominators. If these were both eights, we could just subtract away, but they're not. They're not the same. We have to make them the same. So quickly, find your LCM. Now, there you have 8 and 8, and this is our LCM. So this will be our denominator when we rewrite the problem. You know I like to write them vertically, so I'm going to rewrite 6 and 3/4 and 1 and 5/8 vertically so that I'll have enough space when I make my equivalent fractions, we'll just move over and it'll just slide right on in. So make my denominators an 8. And don't you love it when the denominator is already the same? You can just bring it on over because anything times 1 is the same number. 4 times what is 8? 4 times 2, so do the same to the numerator, times 2 times 2. 3 times 2 is 6. And bring the whole number 6 over. So now we know that 6 and 3/4 means 6 and 6/8. All right, so here is our problem. It's a little crowded, but we need to make sure that we understand that this is subtraction. We are subtracting 6 and 6/8 minus 1 and 5/8. 6 minus 5 is 1. The denominators stay the same. 6 minus 1 is 5. Okay? So here is an example of subtraction. All right, let's do another one. All right, so this example is going to be a little bit different. We'll still evaluate, look at the denominators, 4 and 3. We'll still need to have the LCM, so 4 and 3. And we see that 12 is our LCM. All right, so here will be our denominator when we rewrite the problem. So I'm going to rewrite it going vertically. 4 and 1/4 minus 2 and 1/3. All right. So 12 is my new denominator. And let's think, how do you get from a 3 to a 12? Well, times 4, right? So do the same here. And this becomes 4/12. Now, remember that whole number that's got to go with the problem. Just bring it on over. 4 times what is 12? Times 3. So do the same to the numerator. 1 times 3 is 3. And bring over the whole number. All right. Now, remember the sign. This is where a lot of my students make mistakes, is they forget if they're adding or subtracting. Remember, we're subtracting, so add that sign here. Now, when you're looking at the numerators, we would normally say the 3 minus 4. But you know you can't do that because that would be a negative number. You can't take 4 away from a lesser number. So some regrouping is required. So we're going to take 1 away from the 4. The 4 becomes 1 less, which is a 3. When you take 1 away from the 4 becomes a 3. But because this is not regular subtraction with whole numbers, you can't just put a 1 in front of the 3. This does not become 13. You have to think in terms of, and this is like a thinking bubble over here, think in terms of the whole number becoming a fraction. Now, how can the whole number 1 become a fraction? It has to have that same denominator, 12. And the only way to make a fraction mean the whole number 1, is to have 12 on top, because 12 divided by 12 is the whole number 1. So with that in mind, you're adding 12 twelfths to this fraction to make to add that whole number. So 12 plus 3 is 15. And the denominators always just stay the same. So don't forget your 3. Let's add the 3 back to the original problem. And you can slide this over 2 and 4 twelfths. Now here's our problem. And we've regrouped, we've renamed. 4 and 3 twelfths has become 3 and 15 twelfths. Don't worry that it's improper at this point, because after we subtract, we'll work that out if it didn't work itself out. 15 minus 4 is 11. The denominator stays the same. 3 minus 2 is 1. All right? So now, here is our final answer. This part right here is your most difficult part when renaming. You just remember, whatever the denominator is, it has to be on the top and the bottom to mean the whole number 1. And you're adding it back so that you can subtract. And you'll get it, okay? All right, so here is our last example that we'll work together. This one is different in that we have a whole number and we're subtracting a mixed number. So let's rewrite the problem. The whole number 6. Minus 3 1/2. Now, the most common mistake would be to just say, bring down the 1/2, 6 minus 3 is 3, 3 1/2 is my answer. But that would not be correct, because when you're subtracting, you have to think, well, what am I taking 1 away from? 1 minus nothing, I can't take 1 away from nothing. So I have to have a fraction here in order to take something away. So I'm going to have to do some renaming. So this 6 becomes 1 less. The 6 becomes a 5. And just like we did on the last problem where we had our thinking bubble, we are trying to think, how can I rename that 1 that I borrowed? It has to have the same denominator. Well, the only denominator that I have is the 2, right? So here is my 2, and put a 2 on top, because 2 divided by 2 is the whole number 1. So I know that I can replace this right here, nothing, with 2 over 2, because this means 1. I'm borrowing 1, and I'm putting my 1 here. So now I can subtract. 2 minus 1 is 1. The denominator stays the same. 5 minus 3 is 2. All right? So here is the answer. So always be careful when you're subtracting that you don't just bring down the 1/2 that you think in your mind, how am I subtracting 1/2 from nothing? And make sure that you regroup in order to rename and make this the whole number 1 first. Okay? All right.